It's time. Stand up. I get up. I put it on the show. Lose a show, lose a focus. I come on, be a go get up. I'm gonna stay focused. Opportunities.
I'm just trying to get paid and get that burger, zaga, burger, zaga. Need to dab. Give me some wonko muntu semakai. Need to salute to all my hustlers, my fair to get to us. Manko kula uti mekmele lishomo. Get utlelo is funny. Get on Twitter, get on Instagram, or no matter your Facebook, my fair to. And tell all your friends, it's funny, is in the building. We have my fair to salute to Guanjalo, which is your funa in the base. Ukhlanga tage, ama bongo, ama khebo, my fair to. What a mek, ungani ukuluma nge technology kangaka. Ingoba ke my hustlers, namhlanje sibheka software engineering. Somebody has an to get on Siseko Nomavila. In this organ, I'm going to get the influence the IT. There's that to as it is about fair to what are the Azangis Villa. Job in Musa Conapana, Emma Sanguin. When company is all welcome, Sabachigan, and about fair to everyone's the intellect. So, I'm going to ask 2 months ago, and one of the fair to Peterful Simcombis and his tombe sack. But he cooked on his tombe. It's Snapchat then to a sim shoot.
I'm Ngubane Co, Siseko Nomavila, and I'm 25, ndihlala eRandbeck. Ndikhulela kuQumbu, kwilali ekuthiwa kuseMvumelwano, specifically eNdwane. Ndikhumbula ukuqala kwami ikrish, usuku lam lokuqala, ndandihamba notana. Wafika kwandibeka esikolweni, ndandilila, ndingafuni ukudlala. Ndikhumbula kuthiwa, okay, class makuthandazwe ngoku. Benze uba wonke umntu acimele, so ndacimela ke ndathandaza. Xa ndivula amehlo, damnca kekho uhambile, yabo. So into yam yongathandi isikolo yaqala apha. Ndandingaunderstand uba kutheni ndingazuhlala ekhaya, kutheni ndizohlasa nabanye abantu ndingabaziyo. So yaqala apha.
Igama lam ndinguzama uxolo Nomavila. Ndingutata kaSiseko Nomavila. USiseko esemncinci ube umntana oyafana nabanye abantwana bangamakhwenkwe, you know. Unothi when it comes to being naughty, you know, but respectful as well. And a bit shy kwakhona. Esemncinci ndandiyikhumbula kahle into yoba esemncinci for instance when he started the creche, he didn't want the creche at all. Ndikhumbula uba ndaye ndafowunela kodwa uSiseko sixakile apho ecreche uyabaleke mke, you know.
I remember one time that question schooling. So when that zang in the school when you utata, but why zang you visit? The no question and tell no aunt. So why zang you visit? So why am I going to visit? Why if you get scared, then I get.
That's our time. Now I'm done doing check. Is I can do one. Hey, the school when, Siseko is not the school when. The year boy is ala kona engagelizo. Siseko was playing. Siseko was in school. I guess my parents were in school. Then I had to be firm as a father to say, "Tanam, this is your future." As now I'm done, I'm going to find your team. Then I'm going to be by school ultimately.
Ukhula kwam sasibaninzi ekhaya. Yayingumakhulu, ingutamkhulu. Kukho dabawo bam, ootatomncinci, inoba sasibayi 10, 11, somewhere around there. Utata nomama bona babehlala eMthatha, ngeweekends babedlangoza, bazosivisit. Ufika kwam eMbuqa, ndaphuma, I think ndaphuma position 2, I don't quite remember. And I think that was mostly due to uMisocikwa and iitishala zaseMbuqa zazohlukile kwiitishala ezinye izikolo, so they were very supportive. Yeah, so I think I last support. And then I really blossomed through Zonke as in Ansika in grades. I always got the award for something, third position. I was always somewhere at the top of the class. Go 1997, uzaloka ayabonga umbrother mamncu. Utata wayewahlukana nomama ne.
Xa ndandihlukana nomama akhe wayesencinci kakhulu yena ngelo xesha. And yes, I'm affected, you know, because I'm not going to change the school. African, because it was mid-year, around about April. So he had to change his colo, down for the school of Ngoku, Enga and this.
Book the banana, some colo, that I got sick. On the colo, go bound around by two. And it be challenging, colo, go bana, and does yena and basbona. Go for Negandi tea, the fund was bona, yabo. But ukudibanisa kwakhe nabo ndafumanisa ubana noko ngabantwana.
After matric ndahamba naba then applyile eBay, so they provisionally accepted me. I went and wrote the aptitude test and they told me, okay, cool, you can come register. I'd applied for mechatronics. And the second option was, I think it was applied mathematics. I'm not really sure. I wasn't sure when I'm going to do it. I just needed something in a maths camp because I was good at the maths.
We said, I'm going to apply to engineering, mechatronics. It was a very new word for me. That's mechatronics, what I'm doing.
I'm not quite sure what happened. I think I'd applied for applied mathematics, but somehow good registration, this thing turned into BSc computer science. Yeah, boy. And I was like, okay. So natural as one modules as like, I was like, okay, there's maths here, there's applied mathematics here. I was like, okay, let me do this thing. Yeah, boy. So I wasn't really focused on a major which was computing. I cared that, okay, there's maths here. Let's see how this goes. Yeah, so that's how I got into computer science. I had no idea. So interactions I'm with the computer at the time were very minimal. So Tandy Gofanji Ubas here a lab or something like that. Wasn't really that interested. Banyabandwa Nababe interested, Landom na wasn't interested at it. And little did I know that years later we'd actually meet again and I'd start loving this thing and that would possibly be professional. University second year, I was approached by a professor about this sponsorship that DSTV is giving out. So they wanted about 10 students or something like that. So we went to the interview. So I spoke to one person about the choice. It went well, and then we sponsored everything. So my studies, I had living allowance, they sponsored my books, accommodation, everything was sorted. So my parents didn't have to pay anymore. They sponsored my third year, and then they also sponsored my honors year. I heard about this company called Entelect from a friend of mine, Umatim Chauke. I had no idea about the company, but he was really convinced, well, this is a good company, this is where good programmers go. So I checked it out online, I saw what kind of stuff they do, and I thought it was interesting. I thought it was an interesting company for someone that wants to go into computing, and that's purely what they deal with, computing, nothing else. Yeah. So tomorrow I've got my interview there. I'm hoping it really goes well. I'm a bit nervous, but I hope it goes as I planned for it to go.
I know I'll achieve another interview for you. Good luck, Mdanam. Good luck, Ndoda.
I know he's got a lot of brains. Nangom, so I am sure he's going to make it.
If I get this job, I'll get my own place, which is really great because I've got my own space, got freedom, I can buy what I want to buy, I can do what I want to do.
We'll be right back.
I just walked into Entelect now. Feeling a little bit nervous, as expected. Not really sure what to expect, but I'm hoping for the best.
Hi, Siseko.
Hi, Tish.
Thanks. Welcome to Entelect.
Thank you.
I'm quite interested. How did you hear about Entelect?
I heard from a guy I used to work with at DSTV.
Okay. Do you know much about the company?
I do know a little bit.
Okay.
I know the basics, software services.
Okay.
But besides that, I don't know much.
Okay. We are a software engineering company. We've started out in Johannesburg, South Africa. We are about 350 odd developers now, so quite a big place. It's quite a nice company in terms of software development because we place a lot of emphasis on training and growth in that respect, right?
Okay.
Our core focus is enterprise development. The core languages we work in are Java and C#.
Okay.
So what do you value in your career and what are you looking for in the next?
I'm looking for growth, looking for exciting projects.
Okay.
Okay.
In terms of growth, in terms of the company, I mean, we've got lots of growth opportunities. So from the software engineering role, you could move up into the senior role, and then from there you could look to specialize into either technical lead or team lead.
Okay.
Have you given that any thought in your career as to which area you prefer?
Still a young career.
Okay.
I'd love to develop into a team lead role.
Okay. Okay, let's talk a bit about yourself and we'll take it from there.
Okay.
Can you tell me a bit about why you chose to do computer science as a degree?
I didn't actually choose.
Oh, well.
So I just wanted something that had maths. So I was pretty decent at maths in high school. So I just looked for something that had maths. I tried engineering, but it was too full. And then I eventually landed on applied mathematics, which somehow got converted into computer science. Not really sure how that worked out, yeah. But I thought there's a lot of maths in there, so.
I see you've got 2 years of experience as a software engineer. Can you give me some more detail into the kind of work you were working with, the technologies you used, your kind of role in the team?
Okay, all right. I was in an integration team.
Okay.
Heavily integration based. We integrated with a lot of service providers. We built our solution using Java and Spring.
Okay.
And there's a lot of web services. There's also a lot of messaging as well.
Okay.
With ActiveMQ.
Okay, great.
So it was that kind of work. Not a lot of front end stuff, just mostly back end.
Okay. And did you enjoy the back end
development? I definitely did enjoy the back end development.
Okay.
Found that it's a lot easier to deal with than the front end.
Okay.
Front end stuff.
Okay, are you comfortable though working within the front end if we put you on a project that had
I'd love to get into that. I think it would be interesting working across the whole stack.
Okay, great.
Definitely.
Okay, cool. Now into the more important questions. What do you enjoy doing in your spare time?
A couple of things.
Yes.
I play cricket during my spare time. I'd love making music.
Oh wow, what type of music?
It could be any kind. So I listen to a lot of South African house and a little bit of hip hop. So I try and make that kind of stuff.
It could be
anything really. I guess what's exciting about it is maybe what also excites me about software development is that you make something out of nothing.
Okay.
So you start from scratch, you make something, right?
Okay.
Yeah, which is like your own expression, which is really cool, I think.
Great.
Yeah, so.
And within the software engineering space, are you playing with anything on the side or writing any code or anything like that?
Yeah. So I try and fool around with mobile development. Fascinates me a little bit. So apps are definitely out there at the moment. And I reckon for me that's a lot simpler to deal with than building a web front end,
Great.
Which tends to be a little bit tougher. Yeah, so if I want to see something visually or I need to build that kind of product, I prefer building it on mobile. So that's
Great.
The kind of stuff I do on the side.
Okay,
yeah.
Fantastic. We'd like to see how you actually operate on a daily basis. So what we've done is we've got Jake who runs one of our teams. He'd like to spend some time with you during the day. The first task is with the client. They are already scheduled to come in. They require a new system. You'll join Jake in that process, and then you talk about what you guys are going to develop. Okay. You would write some of the system and then demo it to the client later today. After that, we can meet again. I'd get some feedback from Jake and the rest of the team, okay. And we'll see how you did. Good luck with okay. today. I'm sure you're gonna do well.
Okay. All right.
And I'll see you at around 4 o'clock.
Thanks, Ete.
Siseko o ne a tlameha ho tseba ho hongata ka ha khamphani. Ha e fela di basics. Information e tjena ya tholahala ko di website-eng. Ha holo yena o tseba motho ya sebetsang moo. O ne a tlameha ho ba proactive. Sheba sena ka tsela ena. O apply-la khamphaneng, o batla ho sebetsa moo, o spende nako ya hao e ngata moo. Tseba moo o batlang ho ilo phela teng. Ha le di computer studies, ha di tlhokahale hakalo. Hobane di university ka bongata ba offer a bridging course pele ba ithuti ba ka qala. Siseko yena o tswetse for nthwena o tlhoka senior certificate ya exemption math le physical science di compulsory di computer studies le tsona di ka o thusa ho bala re ha so le software engineer o tlameha ho bana le bohlale haholo o ithute ho sebetsa ka tlase ga pressure mosebetsi wa hao o nepe and hape o tibe le lona ma hustlers focus a mo le batlang ho ya teng ha e mo le tswang teng kapa mo le leng teng
Hustlers, abaningi bethu maqeda ke umatikiletsheni siqonda ngqo emfundweni eyiphakeme ema university bafethu singanalo ke ulwazi oluphelele ngemfundo esizikhethile. Thina ke sifuna ukuthi abangakanani lapha emakhaya abese bashintsha ke izimfundo zabo enyakeni wokuqala bafethu basitshele ukuthi kungani. Awuthi ke ngifake le ndaba ke ibe nenyama ethanjeni bafethu. Uma ke wena uke washintsha kuyini inkinga kusokwazi ke ukwayisa abanye bafethu sibagcinele isikhathi nemali. Ngicela ufake uluvo lweni khona lapha ku Twitter na ku Facebook njengamanje.
My name is Jake Fiomakola. I am a team lead here at Entelect Software. I manage a team of software developers to build custom solutions for clients. I've been in the industry for nearly about 10 years now.
Hi.
Hey man.
Seko, right?
Yes.
Yes.
Jake.
I'm Jake.
Cool. Great. Nice to meet you, man.
I'll be your team lead for the day.
Okay.
We've actually put together a series of tasks for you.
Okay.
To evaluate your fit for the company.
Alright.
In this first session that we're going to have, we've organized a mock client.
Okay.
And the purpose of this meeting is so that you can actually see how it is to engage with a client,
okay.
Get requirements from them, and you know just see how things get kicked off in any project that we begin here.
Okay. All right, cool. And what's my role going to be in that meeting?
So you are going to be the lead in that meeting. I shall
okay.
shadow and guide where necessary.
Okay.
But it is really an opportunity for you to exercise your skills in communicating professionally.
In task one of the tasks that we've actually put forth to Siseko is we'd like to see how he engages with a client. The goal is to see that he's being professional. He can speak clearly, can he understand what it is a client is trying to put across, and most importantly, can he actually devise a solution that the client can then engage with.
www.co.za asengila uyazi bafethu local as black and sabuyele sona iSpani sihamba naye uSiseko bafethu yazi kulamalanga amakhompyutha iwona ke alawula umhlaba bafethu kodwa kusuwonke umuntu ke onale ikhona noma ke ubuhlangane ukuthi alawule amakhompyutha ihustler lethu lithi sizobakhombisa ukuthi angakhona ke ukudizayina isystem yonke iphelele kodwa kuthiwa musukuncama uzawutshiwa zi-frogs awuthi ke ngisebenzisa iy'ngqondo zenu bafethu njenge-app ngimshaye ngiwe jambu lethu yakule viki Into engantshela yona ama-hustlers ukuthi yabona impendulo ihlezi ikhona kuma-task ayenziwa ama-hustlers. Kuzokusiza kakhulu ukuthi ubukele uhlelo bafethu ulalele ngithi impendulo sokunikeza yona njengehewa. Awuthi ngiyenze lula lento lena nginikeze amaletha amabini bafethu which is the letter A and H. Uma usitholile impendulo ngene lapha kuTwitter nakuFacebook ufake A yakho impendulo. Kodwa khona manje asambeke yosobona uSiseko bafethu ashaya ke i-design ye-system. Into engantshela yona ukuthi click on that mouse and press enter siba enterishe.
Hi Soka, this is Theo from AB Comics. He's our client for today from whom I'd like you to elicit requirements from.
When Jake told me about the first task, I was feeling a bit nervous. I think it's a bit of a big deal considering that I'm still a little bit junior. Have to elicit requirements from them and act in a professional manner, mostly feeling nervous.
Good to meet you. Good to meet you.
Likewise, man. So how can we help you?
Right, so I have a couple of comic book stores. We sell comics and action figures and things like that, general merchandise from, you know, the comic world.
Okay.
Most of our stuff is all sort of done quite manually. I don't have a website or anything like that. My clients walk into the store, they buy the comics off the shelves, or they order comics.
Okay.
And then, you know, we sell them to them manually. And when it comes to ordering from my suppliers, that's also a very manual process. I have to dedicate time in the day to my staff to make up these orders, and I find it generally quite time consuming, and it, you know, my business isn't as efficient as I would like it to be.
Okay.
So I came to meet you guys to see how you could potentially help me out.
I believe, as with everything, the first time is always nerve-wracking, especially when speaking to a client for the first time. You know, there's this feeling of that they are superior to you, and that does kind of, you know, affect how it is you think in those sort of discussions.
Okay, cool. So it seems to me like your biggest pain point is the supplier portion of your business, so having to order stuff from your suppliers.
Yeah, as
you say, that
accurate, yeah.
Takes a huge chunk of your time.
Yeah.
With your employees,
yeah,
as well.
Yeah,
cool. So for that, we could give you a nice back office application and let your employees make some orders for you. We could even go as far as automating those orders for you if you know what you usually order per month.
That would be very helpful. We have this call order system for, because comics are periodicals, so
okay,
a comic will come out once a month or once every 2 weeks or something.
Okay.
And if someone wants that, you know, every issue of that as it comes out,
okay,
we don't want them to order each time. So I run what's called a call order for them. So let's say they want Batman every week, then they get Batman every week. But I then have to manually, you know, collate all that information into my orders. So I guess if you could build me a system that could handle something like that, that would be very helpful indeed.
Okay, cool. So it seems to me like there's also a public-facing portion of that application as well. So that's where your clients, which is the public, that make their orders, right? And you guys would have to collate all of that stuff. But we could automate all of that, so you wouldn't have to collate that. All of those would be automatically sent off to your suppliers.
Okay, so the products would the merchandise would be delivered to the clients. So they wouldn't even have to come into the store, is that what you're suggesting?
I'm not sure about delivery.
I hadn't really thought about that. I guess we can discuss that.
Yeah, so we could just focus on the ordering portion on this first go.
Okay.
Right, so client orders, right, and then the back office for the client orders doesn't really need to do much. Right? All of that could be automated, so those orders could be filed off to all your suppliers.
Oh, cool.
Right?
Now, you guys are saying application. Do you mean like a mobile app or like an application on your desktop? I was thinking like a website. Or is that what you mean?
What are you guys using currently? So you and your workers, the admin
pen and paper currently.
Pen and paper.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Yeah. I think a website or desktop application would work well for the back office.
I like the idea of
stuff.
A website, because then, you know, my clients don't have to, you know, download an app or anything. They can just go into the website and have this and everything's there.
Okay, cool. What the client seemed to want is a back office application to allow him and his staff to capture orders, and then a public facing application to allow like clients, the regular comic book buyers, to place their orders as well.
I think for now let's concentrate on a website. I'll have to think about a mobile app. And
absolutely.
I don't know if that's going to necessarily work. We'll see. I'll think about it. But a website for now, definitely.
Just to touch on, you know, our development process is we develop in an agile manner, which essentially means that together we would define the work to be done for your application, and then in small bits and pieces would incrementally build it, and then have sessions with you to go through what we have built to date.
Okay.
And you know, you can give us your feedback in that way. That way we essentially are building the application together. You know?
Okay, so I'd see it, you know, in stages throughout the process. Oh, that's wonderful.
And in that way, you know, at the end of it all, the benefits are that you get exactly what you want, as opposed to coming back 2 months later and essentially getting a lemon.
One of the benefits of software engineering that people in general would have benefited from, so 10 years ago, 15 or so, people would actually walk into a bank to transfer money from one account to another. In this day and age, you can do that directly from your cell phone. And what's on your cell phone that you're interacting with is an application that is purpose-built to perform that function and many others, you know. So it does, in essence, make life easier for people and also improve business processes.
Well, when can I expect to see it?
Okay, by the end of the day, we can show you a basic mock-up of the back office application.
Okay, what do you mean by mock-up?
So it's not the actual, don't be the actual site, but
okay. You
get an idea as to how it would look, how it would operate.
Okay, okay. So it's just like a prototype almost or something like that.
Effectively, yes.
Exactly.
Perfect, yeah, that sounds great.
During the first task, I think I did decently. I think I didn't get as much detail as I would have liked to get out of the client. Got enough to get going, but I thought I could have asked the client a little bit more to sort of get a clearer picture of what they wanted.
In task one, I feel Siseko performed quite well at a first attempt. He spoke to the client and actually allowed the client to present the ideas that they had. I would suggest that he further actually allow the client more time to digest what it is that they're actually thinking, because the goal of this process is essentially to get as much detail from the client as possible. And they often have an idea of what it is that they want, but they will present it in their own way. So just be cognizant of the client's personality.
Siseko, o analytical. O supile utlwisiso e ntle ka bothata ba client and hape o na le bokgoni ba go tla ka dintlha tsa tharollo. Computer science le computer literacy ha di tshwane. Computer literacy e ruta baithuti gore ba kgone go sebedisa computer. Ba kgone go sebedisa dintho tse tshwanang le di-word processor, di-spreadsheet, di-presentations le tse ding tse tibileng. Mahustlers, gore le seke la nyahama, emelela o etse go gongwe. O seke wa emela dintho gore di tle go wena. E tswa o ile o etsa go gotle, o tla bona, o tla tlala ka tumelo and hape o tla kopana le dintho tse tshepisang. Go bana le bokgoni ba tharollo le go di tlhalosa ga se ntho e e le gore ya tshwana. Dintho tsena tse pedi ke dintho tse shebilweng go tswa go Siseko ko tasking ya gae e e latelang.
Siseko, we're about to start task number two.
Okay.
In this task, I'd actually like you to draw on our whiteboard how it is that you'd actually build this application.
Okay.
What the different tiers are that exist, and ultimately what the front end is going to look like.
Okay.
All right.
Cool, man.
In task two, I'd ideally like to see Siseko's ability in developing code. So we've essentially put together a couple of subtasks which he'd execute in order. First one being to put together a basic framework of a website which will fulfill the client's requirement in terms of people interfacing with the application. And the second would then be an API. Now, an API is an application that receives commands and data from the website, processes it, and either stores it or returns it back to the website in a transformed manner. In task two, what I'd like to see is Siseko's technical ability. I'd like him to put together an architecture diagram of how it is he envisions building the system, and also immediately go straight into the development of that system. Siseko,
mm-hmm.
Could you please demonstrate how the architecture of the solution would look?
Okay. So we'd have our database down here. And then just above that, we'd have our data access layer. Right. So this is the guy that exposes all our CRUD operations into the database. On top of that, we'd have our business layer, right? So this is where all the processing happens, if we've got any logic decisions that we might need to make. Sitting on top of that is our API. So that's the interface to our backend. That's where we expose all the methods, processes that the front end, which is our client application, is gonna need to make. So that guy would speak to that guy, to our API.
Yeah.
And if in the future we decide to have a mobile app, then that guy would also speak to our API.
All right. Yeah. Can you just highlight what kind of database would you use here?
Okay.
And what technology would constitute the entire API business layer and data access layer?
In terms of complexity, the actual use case itself is not that complex, but these things tend to be complex in the sense that you need to connect a lot of moving parts together. So you're effectively going down all the layers and making sure everything works together nicely.
Could you now show me a mock-up of the ordering screen, just okay. So we have an idea of what it is that we're actually going to be developing?
Okay. Okay, cool. So that's our user screen. So we'd have a list of our comics here. Yeah, so the user's got the option to select whatever comic they want. Mm-hmm. So once they click on the actual comic, then we'll display a little bit of detail about the comic, yeah. Right? And then we'd give them a button down here that gives them the option to order the comic, right? So once you click on this button, you'd then be redirected to another screen.
Okay.
Yeah.
I suggest a possible way to make that simpler is that mm-hmm. when they click on the order button, you okay. can actually show a pop-up that has all the ordering information cool. on that screen. So there'd be less screens actually then to design.
Yes, definitely. And that's also a bit quicker as well.
Okay, great yeah. stuff. All Let's right. move on to the computers and start developing.
Cool, man. Thanks.
Great. Come through.
So code is a set of instructions you run on a computer. So usually, if you're dealing with computers, you've got an end goal, right? There's something you want to achieve at the end. So in our case, you want to place an order, right? So you need to go through a series of steps, and the way you do that is by writing code.
Seko, could you please write the code that will store this new order?
Okay. So we'd have two functions. Order input object.
Mm-hmm.
Is it order input?
Yeah, it is order input.
Okay, and then we'd have another function for the update, right?
You tell me.
So in our new, we'd have our order objects that we're gonna get from our order repo. Repo. Let's get by ID. Input. Dot. Get ID. Can't do that.
The great thing about today is the internet has truly made life easy. You can go online today and basically type in how to program and present it with a multitude of tutorials that actually teach you how. You could within 30 minutes or so actually have your own website up and running because of the basic information that is available and detailed enough to allow you to build a basic application all the way through to a very complex one. It truly comes down to what it is you want to achieve at the end of the day.
So after those changes, I've relaunched the application.
Mm-hmm.
And let's just refresh them and see how it looks. So if you go to place order, cool, and you click on any one of these items. So I like that guy. And you hit order more. Then you can choose your supplier. So that's going to be part of the order input object. You can choose the condition. So let's say you want it to be fine. Let's leave those out. Okay, and if you go order, then the actual order is made. Order placed successfully. If that wasn't successful, then it wouldn't come back with that.
Okay, great stuff. Now we can actually present this application to the client later today.
Superb.
Cool. Software developing ke go bopa ditshebediso tsa ka hare. And Siseko o tlhalositse seo hantle ka lenaneo. Go ithutela computer science kapa electronic engineering ke potso e tlwaelegileng. Empa di le pedi di botlhokwa haholo, di a batlagala. Ba graduateileng moo he, ba thola mesebetsi e tshwanang. And di le pedi di tlhophisa baithuti gore ba sebetse ko computing industry. Mahustler se, ga e ka ba o na le kgatlhego lekaleng le itseng, empa o sena ditlhokwa fo nako eo kapa o sena tšhelete, tseba gore tsela e nngwe e teng. Le ga e ka go nka nako, qetellong o tla fitlha. Ha se ka palong fela empa dithuto tse dingata di leetong. Ha ile Siseko dintho di a kopana ko tasking ya boraro ha a buisana le client and hape ha ba kwala project.
Siseko, we're about to start task 3. Okay. This is now where you are going to demonstrate that application that you've built to the client.
Okay.
Are you ready for this?
Yeah.
Right. Okay. Just a few pointers.
Okay.
Keep calm and pay attention to the feedback that they provide.
Okay.
It's crucial that we end this meeting with enough for us to then proceed with, and also for them to feel confident that we are actually delivering what they want.
Okay. All right.
All right.
Okay.
Let's go.
Cool.
In task 3, Siseko is going to be demonstrating the application that he has built to the client. In this process, we usually expect the client to give us feedback, which we will then collate and actually go back and then update the applications to suit the exact need. So it is going to be a dialogue between the two of them. And what I'd like to see is him guide the client in thinking the way that results in the client ultimately getting what they want.
Hey, yo. I'm tired of using technology. Uyabona ke uSiseko bafethu uyizonda kabi leyo ngoma. Njoba ke uyinsizwa ke ethandwa ukusebenza ngetechnology bafethu, asebenze ngama computer, njoba ke afise ukuba i-software engineer. Kodwa ke ngaphambi simbona laphana a repapa lento ayifinalize bafethu, ngathi uTI oshayi IT bafethu. Ngiyabona laphana ukuthi iword jumble, inshanga ama punchline, or should I say punch word. So uthi ninqede bafethu ninikeza ama clue amabini bafethu, which is the letter G and T. But right now, let's take a tea break. We'll be back and try to crack the code. Into ngitshela ukuthi manje sithathe careful and click on refresh, refresh, refresh. Sebuya.
This demonstration to the client is probably going to be the most challenging task Siseko is actually involved in. This is because at this point you have to really prove to the client that the effort that you put in actually was worth it and that you actually truly did understand their initial requirements. I'm sure he's going to be very nervous, but what I hope to see is that he holds the nerves back and communicates clearly to the client and, you know, out of this entire process gets valuable feedback that he can then act upon going forward.
Cool. Welcome back, Theo. So now we're going to go through what we've actually done. So we've implemented placing of an order for the admin application.
Mm-hmm.
So that's where you and your employees would actually place the orders. Right? So you can go inside an order, place an order, choose your supplier, that kind of thing.
Right? Okay.
So let me show you how it looks. So if you go to place order.
Yeah, I see you've got some images there, that's quite cool.
Yeah, so that's your catalog of comics, right? And then if you want to place an order, you can select any one of them. Right, so we select this guy, right? So you get a little bit of detail on the side here about the comic itself. Right, you get to see when it was published, who it was published by. You get a nice view of the image.
Okay.
Right, you see that we've got a button where you can actually place an order. Alright, so if we click on that guy, then you can choose your supplier. So you've got your list of suppliers, you know where you want to be placing orders or who you want to be placing orders with. So if you click on the drop down, you can select your guys there. Alright, so click on one of the guys. And then we've got this cool guy here where you can select the condition of your comic.
Okay.
Alright, yeah, so if you want it really fine, then you can go up
I don't see why we would ever order a poor condition comic book.
Okay,
it's all fine.
Okay, yeah, these are customizable options.
Are they customizable?
So, yes, the flexibility in the solution will allow you to define your own conditions.
Okay, great.
All right, cool.
I see you've got a suppliers tab there as well. Is that for sort of managing that stuff?
Yeah, so that's managing your suppliers. So if it ever happens that you've got new suppliers, you want to delete suppliers, the guys are not supplying anymore, or anything like that, then you've got that, right? So you've got a
search box there at the top?
That's a search.
Yeah, right. We've got quite a few suppliers, so that'll definitely be very handy.
Yeah, definitely. And you can search by any of these fields. These three fields here, so you can search by name, by city, by reference number. You don't really need to specify it. You just, so for instance, if we look at these guys, they are in the city, you can search by that.
That's
if you wanted to search by their name, you could still do that and you've still got them. So, yeah.
Fantastic.
Cool.
Okay. Do you want my comments?
Definitely.
Okay. Can you go back to that order page?
Okay.
It feels kind of strange that everything's all on the left here, and then we've just got this white panel here on the right.
Yeah.
I know this is just like quite a quick demo that you put together. So obviously this isn't finalized.
Yeah, this needs to look better. I agree.
Yeah. And also the images from these comics. Could they not be the covers of the comics? These look like images just sort of taken from within.
Yeah, these are just
like
pictures I took off the internet.
I'm looking more for sort of like an A4.
Yeah, we definitely have the actual covers of the comics. Okay. These are just pictures we pulled off the internet.
Okay.
Because we're not in a production environment. This is just a testing environment.
Okay, can you search for comics at the moment, or is it only what's here?
You cannot at the moment, so it's only what's here.
Okay, I'll definitely need that functionality in the future.
Yeah, that's definitely something we're going to build.
So what we shall be doing is, with all this feedback that you're giving us now, we're logging it together with all the other things that we plan to develop. And then what we can do then is in our next development cycle, we together can actually choose which components it is that we'll build for that for those 2 weeks before the next demo, where we'll then show you the result of that development. So that way you yourself can actually see the progress and, again, you are continuously involved in this development.
Excellent.
Okay.
What other comments would I have? So at the moment, anyone can just hit this page. Could we have something where like a client could log in, and have their own account and maybe, have like a shopping cart or something like that? They could, add things to their shopping cart and, choose quantities and that kind of stuff. Something like that. I mean, they could track their orders, set up call orders, that kind of thing.
Yeah, we can add all of that to your feature list.
Okay. And then obviously my clients mustn't, my customers mustn't be able to order stuff from the suppliers. That's only for my staff.
Yes, definitely.
That's for ordering stock for the shops.
Yeah, so there will be security for that stuff. We just wanted to get to the nuts and bolts of your problems, which is placing orders and that kind of stuff. Yeah.
Great. I think that's all the comments I have for now.
Okay.
It's great feedback.
All right. Yeah, it is.
So I've gotten feedback from Jake, and I've seen some of your solution.
Yeah.
It's good. I mean, there's different growth areas that we can help you in. But overall, it was a really good solution. I think technically you ticked all the boxes for us. Your confidence and communication skills were all great. You service the client well. Your ability to convey your solution was good. So I was very happy with today. So thanks for spending the day with us. Hopefully you got something out of it as well.
Yeah,
how was your day? Did you enjoy it?
It was good, yeah. I enjoyed it. I think it's cool that you give guys that level of responsibility. Right, so I definitely enjoy that portion of it.
Okay.
Getting to interface with the client a lot more.
Okay, and does Entelect seem like a place you'd want to work for?
Yes, okay, I think it's a cool culture. Jake was really cool, I thought, and some of the guys I met here.
Okay. Great. So it's a win from our side as well. Thanks.
Okay. Cool.
Thanks, Yatish. Thanks, Siseko. So based on all the feedback I've received from Jake and the rest of the team, based on the solution you provided, it's clear to me that you're definitely an Entelect, a capable employee. So we'd like to offer you a position. We'll do all the paperwork and that later. You can expect a mail from us, but we'd be happy to have you on our team. Thanks for everything and congratulations on the job.
Thanks,
man.
Thanks, Yatish. Hi guys, so I got the job. It was a bit of a challenging day, but exciting at the same time. I'm quite happy with where I am at this moment. It's just another step forwards in my career. That means I can get the things I want in life, so that independence that I always yearn for. Yeah, so it's all good, quite happy. To all the hustlers out there, presa, pusha, panda.
Well done, Siseko. Re ithutile go wena and hape o iprovile ntlha e reng nka maikarabelo le maikemisetso diqetong tsa gago empa o be flexible diketsong tsa gago. Potso ya rona ya beke ena e tswa ko Nomfundo. A re ena o batla go tseba gore menyetla ya mesebetsi ke e feng ga e ka ba o na le National Diploma in Legal Assistant. Di-legal assistant kapa tsona di-paralegals ba na le botsebi haholo ka tsa molao. Bona mosebetsi wa bona ko o sebedisana le di-client tsa bahiri ba bona go ba thusa go rarolola mathata a molao, go batlisisa le go beakanya di-case for kantoro ya tsa molao. Menyetla ya mesebetsi ya tholagala mane ko di-legal firm, ko di-banke, the insurance company, money the deeds office, le the estate agent o ka fumana monyetla. Mosebetsi wa hao o tla ya ka o fapana ho ya ka mohiri wa hao. Ha e ka ba hona le ho sa utlwang kapa ho fumanang, hopola o tshekela Facebook kapa website ya rona. Ke emetse ya hao putso.
Hustlers, yabona kule mhlaba bafethu sifuna ukuba imkhonto yesizwe, insika yesizwe, sibizwe ngabomnomzana abathize. Yabona ke uSiseko bafethu abambiza ngomnomzana njengoba ke asithelele umsebenzi omusha njenge-software engineer khona laphana ke e-Entelect. Simfisele yonke inhlanhla ekhona mfethu emhlabeni ukuthi izinto zakhe zihambe babaphi. Into engatshelayo ukuthi yabona ke uma ulapha ekhaya nawe ke iba njenge-hard drive. Impilo uma iba nzima mfethu, drive harder. See what I just did there? Computers, hard drive, angisekho lapho. Sikho isikhathi ukuthi manje nginikeze impendulo khona laphana ku word jumble. Igama akade silifuna bafethu yi algorithm. Uma ke uyitholile hayi ngempela unerhythm. Uma ke ungayitholanga ngithi ujayiva ngathi umenyiwe. Hayi sikubona next week. Mina kumfana kaMtambo kudansa zonke intambo sengiphuma kanje. Akahlangane khona laphana ke enkundleni zokuxhumana bafethu, iTwitter neFacebook, and please cela nisibhekeni khona laphana ku YouTube. Ungakhohlwa ukubukela ama repeats ngo 11 o'clock ngo Thursday. Mina ngihlala ngitshela ngithi don't look down, look up and stay up. Until next week. Goodbye.
Thank you.